Oh my God, did she have to write everything in a made-up Jewish code? Fucking Marshall with her CIA spy shit, God. In there, and we go around that way. Now,
any idea what it does?
Ah, that is a jukebox token. Little bastards turn up in the weirdest places, like bad pennies. The Rangers use them to activate an old object of power.
A jukebox, I assume. Does it have any good songs?
Nope, just the one record. Hey, be careful turning it on, though. When it's playing, you get a free trip to the formation.
The formation? That sounds ominous.
Why does it send you there?
The Bureau has been wondering that for years. I mean, it's just a pile of rocks built by God knows who, but... Well, researchers have confirmed it's in the same threshold as the quarry. Well, no one's ever been able to map a physical route to the formation for maintenance.
So it's in the quarry. You just don't know where.
Pretty much. We only send in annual expeditions to the formation now. Checkups, Salvador calls them. This year's team went in the day the hiss arrived. Come to think of it, the song should have brought him back hours ago.
I can go in and take a look.
I'd appreciate that. The jukebox is kept just past the security booth over there. Just put in the token and enjoy the ride.
What's the deal with BlackRock?
Oh, fuck. Don't get me started on BlackRock. You know, ever since research found out that it blocks paranormal stuff, they have just been parading dangerous materials in and out of the fucking quarry. Fucking lab coats, man. Love making my job harder.
Sounds like there's some tension between departments.
Still, at least the quarry's got a good view of the night sky. You know, me and Salvador used to have after-work beers down there.
What do you know about Dr. Darling?
About as much as anybody, I guess. Head of research, loves to hear himself talk. All of those science types absolutely do. He's been acting a little bit psycho recently. Although HR told me not to use that word, so...
Everyone thinks finding Darling will lead us to the answers. But if he's completely lost it, then what help could he be?
You're security, right? Do you work with Rangers?
Not often. Rangers are specially trained in threshold reconnaissance and ground zero AWE response. Security is more interested in the dangers inside the Bureau.
They must see some weird stuff out there.
Oh yeah, definitely. You know, every week they are tackling things that were previously unknown to the human experience. Most Rangers, they retire due to cognitive collapse. I looked up the medical definition. Not fun.
How does the Bureau handle thresholds?
Handle might be a bit of an optimistic way to put it. Marshall sends the Rangers in to map them, check growth rates, locate epicenters, take samples, measure stuff, basically.
Sounds like he's done his homework.
Now, down in maintenance, thresholds are used just like any other tool. Lab coats mine black rock from one, maintenance siphons water from another. We use it for pretty much everything, except drinking.
Why don't you drink it?
Do I even want to know?
Yeah, a lot of time we find these little chunks in it. It's, pretty gross.
I didn't want to know.
What do you think of Marshall?
Marshall? Marshall's a fucking badass. Rangers could not ask for a better leader. She's a little, intense, but given the stuff she's seen, I'm not surprised. She does have a bad habit of disappearing, though.
Where does she go?
Last time she vanished, I did some digging into the security logs. I found camera footage of her entering the quarry. She was down there alone for days. Now, typically that's not allowed, but Marshall is kind of above the rules.
I wonder what she finds so interesting in the quarry.
I have to go.
Me too. You're not the only one who's busy, you know.
We're gonna get through this.
The resonance emitted from the HRAs is purely antithetical to every variant of the hiss signal I could arrange.
It's happening. After all these years, Dylan is here. But am I too late?
How is he? I need to know.
He's clearly been affected by the hiss, but it's different than any other manifestation we've recorded. Maybe what makes you so special is genetic. He was a prime candidate. Or maybe it's Polaris protecting him, something else affecting the situation. I need to run tests. He seems more in control, more present.
I want to see him.
My brother? Or is he?
Of course. Now, Marshall set up an HRA-warded cage to contain him. It's on the upper floor, up the stairs.
Okay, I need to go.
Jesse, be careful. Hi, Jesse.
I should be going. Enjoy your data.
Oh, I will.
Hey there, Fate.
That's Dylan. Can you hear me? Oh, come on, Dylan. I'm here. I found you. Do you know who I am? Oh, you know me. Say it.
You are Dylan Faden's sister.
He's talking in the third person. Always a good sign. Do you know who you are?
Not Dylan. Trench and Darling made sure of that. I'm P6. P6. But I'm better now. The hiss made me better.
Push the fingers through the surface into the wet. You've always been the new you. You want this to be
true. Can you stop that? Please. Not exactly the reunion I'd hoped for.
It feels good to say those words. I want to say them. They sound good. They make me feel good. Don't you want to say them too?
No. Fuck off, no. You need to help me get this thing out of his head. If he is still in there, if there is anything left, you have to help me.
You came in through the hole in you. We let you in. You've always been here. The only truth. A copy.
Stop it!
Orangefield!
Shit! He can see you. This is not safe.
We found Polaris together with my sister when we were very small. In ordinary. In the desert. Through the door opened up by the slide projector. But she didn't help when Trench took me away. She didn't give me any powers. All the powers are my own powers. She didn't help when they locked me up for years.
After the song time for applause, we build you till nothing remains. The egg cracks and the truth will emerge out of you. You are home.
The Bureau brought the slide projector back here with me. And the Bureau did what the Bureau does. They used it. And they found... They opened the door up to the hiss. That's the only thing I can thank them for.
There. There it is. We stopped the altered world event in ordinary when we shut down the slide projector. And now the projector's here.
An earworm is a tune you can't stop humming in a dream. Baby, 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 yeah. Just plastic. So safe. Nothing to worry about. Funny.
I welcomed the hiss. I let it in. To get rid of her. The hiss set me free. Polaris is using you. The Bureau is using you. You are a puppet.
You can almost hear our words, but you forget.
If we shut off the slide projector, maybe that will stop the hiss.
In your regulations.
Maybe it's not too late for my brother.
You must see the truth for yourself, Jesse. Sister. The horrible truth about the Bureau. The hiss is the better option. Go to the Prime Candidate program in the containment sector. I have the keycard to get you there. Salvador wanted me to have it.
Wanted? Bullshit. I saw what the hiss did to Salvador. What it turned him into.
Okay, Dylan. I'll go. I want to see the truth for myself.
I'll go. But only to look for this lie projector. You can help me. We can end this.
You are a worm through time. The virus distorts you. Happiness comes. White hurts, but yellow and red in the eye. Through a mirror, the inverted is on the right.
I don't know what else I'm hoping to find here.
Dylan. Can we talk?
I'd like to tell you about a dream I had last night.
Off to a good start.
Okay. I'm listening.
I was back in Ordinary. Before all of this happened. But in the dream, I was alone. It was just me. I was the only child. A girl. My name was Jesse Dylan Faden. But then the Bureau came and caught me, brought me back here, locked me up. Have you ever noticed that our names, Jesse, Dylan, they could be girls' names, boys' names, could be anything. Don't you find that weird? I find that weird.
Sure.
What the hell was that? Is he trying to mess with me?
You are a worm through time. The thunderstorm distorts you. Happiness comes. White burns, but yellow and red in the eye. Through a mirror of the inverted sun.
Guy.
I heard the ranger saying you saved them at maintenance. They were attacked by a new kind of hiss, and Arish got them out.
All right, but still, a security...
Thank you. Did you see that hiss they marched through here? Why the fuck didn't we put a bullet in that thing's head?
I heard it's the director's brother. Did you shoot your brother?
That's my... Marshall orders us to just sit on our asses and then leaves?
Just when I thought things were stabilizing, Marshall abandons us. I'm sick of knowing what's going on.
Well, I need to fucking know. I'm an upper-level executive, damn it.
What can I do to help? Stop by any time.
Oof. Lots of errors on this form.
This is Lynn Salvador, head of Bureau Security. I'm making a formal security order due to the incident in April. Case number 21HQ593. Improper use of the jukebox altered item led to two fatalities. We believe a pair of agents used the jukebox to travel to the quarry threshold and engage in inappropriate workplace behavior. An expedition team found them decomposing at the formation's base a week later. At least we found out the jukebox doesn't bring corpses back when the song ends. I'm having the jukebox placed in a secure location in the executive sector. It should never have been accessible to low clearance staff in the first place. The new location's security and proximity to a high traffic area will prevent misuse while still allowing for expedition teams to access it when required. See me for any further details.
Thank you.
see it. Another object of power? They're just standing there, mesmerized by it.
State your name for the record.
Paul Warren, astronaut, first class.
And you are aware that exposure to the astral plane can result in death, disability, personal injury, corporeal entangling, cognitive collapse, loss of ego, and partial to full dementia?
Yeah. I am.
And you acknowledge that your use of the astral conduit, aka the X-ray light box, is purely voluntary?
Yes, I do.
Perfect. Your suit is good?
Yeah.
Okay, you're all set. Open the door for Mr. Warren, please.
Thank you.
Their brains were fried when I took over the object.
Thank you. Thank you. Gibson, male, age 28, returned from the astral plane approximately 13 minutes ago. This was his 21st dive. Patient is experiencing migraine-like pain, intense pressure behind the eyes. Of his time in the astral plane and appears severely disoriented. Preliminary examination.
You are a warrior, the song of your song is a sacred song. You are a warrior, you are a warrior.
I wish things had gone differently in Ordinary for us. Wishing won't change things. Finding the projector will.
So much coming together in this one case. A new object of power, something we have not seen before. I mean, coming from me, that's saying something. And the boy, Dylan Faden. Prime Candidate 6. And the sister as well. Once we catch up with her, but the boy. So much potential. We're talking Northmore level readings here. And I don't want to invoke his name, but it's completely different circumstances here. It's remarkable. There was an incident. Yes. Lost a valuable member of our team, yes. Excessive force. Dylan has so much. But he's just a kid. I'll take the blame. He needs some slack. I mean, boys will be boys. He's exceptional and under a lot of stress. Roberts got killed. It's an unfortunate accident, that's all. Marshall needs to realize this. We will make this work. We'll make this work.
Is this what Dylan wanted me to see? It doesn't matter. We need to find that projector. All the times I felt paranoid, I was right. The Bureau could have given me the answers, but they just stood by and watched me.
We used to pray there all the time. Me and Dylan, and other kids as well. We loved it. This time, I remember, was different. We found a way in, deeper into it, like it had shifted. We went inside, and that's where we found the slide projector.
A dump is a place for lost things. Things that have been thrown away. Did you ever feel that way when you were growing up, Jesse?
What? No. Yes, but that has nothing to do with...
Was there a slide projector at your home when you were small?
No.
Those were before your time, I suppose.
But your family did look at photos together, maybe. In one form or the other?
Maybe.
When was this? Can you remember? At parties? Barbecues? How did it make you feel? Did your parents ever show pictures that embarrassed you? Was alcohol ever involved at these parties? Did your parents drink? Did that make you uncomfortable?
No! That's just stupid! Come on! That has nothing to do with this. Nothing! This slide projector...
Let me ask you this. As a child, did you ever fantasize about worlds inside pictures? Inside a painting? You know, stepping into a painting, into a hidden world, escaping and finding adventure there, away from your parents.
I don't think so. I don't remember. Maybe.
They studied what happened in Ordinary here. That's the place to start looking.
Thank you.
candidates. Experiments. Very different ones, sure, but both in a cell of some sort. Am I out of the cell now, or is all this, the house and being the director, just another cell? Who's really in charge here? Going back home. Of course we are. It started there, and it's never gone away.
Thank you.
There's gotta be a way to rotate these tracks. Maybe there's a control panel nearby.
Thank you.
to America overnight, celebrating 29 years shining a light in the shadows. Thanks for staying with us. Here's our first caller.
What am I about to tell you? They found out. I don't know what would happen.
Who found out, brother?
The men in the suits. They told me it was an industrial accident. But this is something else. Something nobody talks about. Ordinary.
This certainly doesn't sound very ordinary, caller.
No, not ordinary. Ordinary. It's a talent. And it wasn't an industrial accident. I mean, that's what they said. But that's bullshit.
Whoa, please watch that. I'm
sorry. It's just my brother lived there. They said the town was destroyed, but it wasn't. I went there. The people are gone, but the town's there. It's still there.
So the population of an entire town disappears, yet the town remains. Tell me, was the phrase "there is no salvation" written anywhere?
I'm not sure.
The same thing happened in Brazil in 23, a village called Hor Verde. More than 600 people just up and left. The government said they were fleeing guerrilla forces, but we know the truth. A mass abduction, as predicted by my regular guest, Dr. Quincy Wayne.
Abduction? You mean aliens? That's bullshit! I know they're lying!
Now I warned you about the language, caller. I'm afraid we're gonna have to cut you off. And good timing, too. It's time for a short break. Hang in there. America Overnight will be right back.
Curious correlation with the yet unknowable forces intruding upon our world in the form of altered world events. These forces gravitate toward archetypal objects, a gun, a television, a supposedly haunted house. So clearly humanity affects this process. Our collective unconscious is a map of sorts. We hold the key, but we don't know how to use it. We create these archetypes through everyday life. Popular culture, urban legends, but we are observing and influencing a complicated system in action. We can change the likelihood of something being a receptacle for these forces just by thinking about it. But we haven't found a method to control the outcome. And yet, there's something unique in us, in our dreams, in the conceptual reality with power, with our minds. What's the cause and what's the effect? Are we the starting point or just a necessary evil in this? A byproduct, a reflection, a projection? We'll struggle to find the answers to these hard questions. Or do I try?
annual evaluation of Dylan Faden, formerly P6, performed by Dr. Carl Levon. The questions asked here correspond to the fifth iteration of the Gunner's psychological assessment. Are you ready, Dylan? Let's begin then. In a single word, describe the world around you.
Where's Casper?
Dr. Darling is out of the building today.
He's never out. He didn't want to come, did he? He never visits, not since Roberts. To tell Darling it wasn't my fault. I couldn't control it yet, but I can now. I learned. Will you tell him?
In a single word, describe the world around you.
A prison. A cold, empty prison. Not even a poster on the wall.
Mm-hmm. What is the next number in the sequence 3, 6, 9, 12, 15?
18.
What day is it today?
How the hell would I know? It's not like you give me a calendar.
You find a rabbit in the woods. It is breathing, but not moving. You cannot see any blood. What do you do?
Leave it.
Expand on that.
It doesn't matter. The rabbit's not real. None of it's real.
What day is it today?
Do you enjoy asking people questions that can't be answered? Is this what gets you up in the morning? What you dreamed of doing as a scared, stupid little girl?
Can you describe a dog to me?
In ordinary, we had a friend. Nosebleed Neil. And when it all went crazy, you know what I mean. Nosebleed Neil turned into a dog. Or something like a dog.
What day is it tomorrow?
Fuck off! I don't know! There is no calendar! How can I fucking know?
Dylan, calm down.
Fuck you! Fuck you and fuck Casper! Hey, are you watching this, you old fuck? Did you send your bitch because you're too scared of me? Where is Casper?
Security, get a team in here. I need...
See what they have on ordinary. It's all here. Our home, our school, the woods, the dump. they recreate that too? Is that where they keep it? Say when you visit your childhood home, everything feels small, like a miniature, not real. They got that right.
You mentioned a poem last time we talked. By Thomas Zane?
Yes. Beyond the shadow you settle for, there's a miracle illuminated.
I looked the poem up.
Only I couldn't find any poet by that name. I did find a European filmmaker who moved here in the 60s, named Thomas Zane.
What?
I don't...
No matter.
It suits you very well, the poem. How you see things. Maybe you wrote it yourself.
I didn't.
No. You've said a few times that you feel like there's a piece of you missing. Can we talk about that?
Okay. Yeah, it's this. I feel an emptiness, a yearning for something that I think I lost.
It's natural for you to feel that way. Your brother and your parents are dead.
No! No. Doolin's not dead. And that's not even it.
You're referring to the imaginary friend from your childhood?
Polaris. She's come back. After a long time, she's calling me. In a dream I saw, she showed me things.
Jesse.
It felt more real than anything. As real as what happened in Ordinary.
The industrial accident in your hometown? That you believe Polaris caused?
No! It wasn't an accident! There was no industrial accident, and Polaris didn't cause it! She saved me and Dylan.
Jesse...
No! It was a cover-up. The government knows about it. There were agents there. Agents from... I don't know exactly, but they took Dylan. They... I'll find them. I won't stop looking. Polaris wants me to go to New York. There's a building there. I have to leave soon. I have to be there at a very specific time. Something hugely important is going to happen.
Jesse, you know we can't let you go until you're well. And that begins by understanding what's real and what's imagined.
moved the whole landfill here in the middle of New York, and nobody saw a thing. Pretty unbelievable.
Thank you.
We should check that lab.
Effective immediately. I'm setting up a new department. Dimensional research in the research sector. Transferring the slide projector there. That's where my focus will be now. The ordinary site remains as is. We'll be back to... I don't know when.
Darling took the projector to the research sector. He dedicated a whole area to it, so he knew it was important. Dimensional research. That's where we go next.